Hey guys, Dexter here. Welcome to my channel. Today, I'm going to share with you how could we implement the example that we covered last time into a real database, Microsoft Access. If you haven't got a chance to look at the database, make sure to check out the video so that we are on the same page. As we remember, database was about activity participation of students. So there are two tables. One is about the activity participation and another is about the students' information. Before we start, we try to break down the activity column into a separate table. So now we got another table for the activity, activity ID, and also some of the details. Let's get started on the Access environment. Hit thumbs up and comments down below. Also subscribe to my channel. After we launch the Microsoft Access, you see there the bring up templates. But actually, we already got our design ready, so we can skip all of them and then just start with a blank database. Before we start, there is a default table down there for us to fill in something. At this point, I think we should start with modeling a student table. At the upper left corner, there are two fields down there for us to select the datasheet view and the design view. For the datasheet view, it is about filling or editing all the data. For the design view, it is about changing the structure of the database. We should try to define a structure before we move on. First, I go to the design view. The first table we're gonna work on should be the students table. Refer to our design. The first one should be the student ID. For the data type, I decided to skip all the details here. We just try to choose all of them as short text here. The next one is the student name, class number. As we have already defined all the field name, let's move on to the keys. The first one is already selected as the primary key by default, but you can also choose other fields as primary key. In our case, the first one should be fine. So let's stick to the first one, the student ID as the primary key here. At this page, it is also convenient for us to look at the aspects on the domain integrity first. In Microsoft Access, the domain integrity can be done with the function of the validation rule. You can try to define an expression with the expression builder if you like, but I think for most of us, this is a lot of things. I think you better not mess with this. My advice is just go to Google and find a couple of cheat sheets. There are a lot of them available. I've randomly picked two of them that I find useful. I post them up on the description box down below. For student ID, as we look at the data example, it should start with S and then 7 characters. It should be like S and then all the numbers. This is how we define the validation rule for the student ID. For a student name column, it should only allow alphabets and spaces. So the expression is like this one. For the class, simple and straightforward, we can just try to draft up the expression without even looking at cheat sheets. We assume that this is a secondary school in Hong Kong. We only got form 1 to form 6. Class A to E. And also for the class number, usually less than 40 students within the class. It should be between 1 and 40. We are done with the domain integrity part. How about the index? As we covered in the last video, index is like a system to maintain a list of sorted items so that the users can retrieve the data pretty quickly. By default, in Access is already enabled for the index part. If we'd like to also have the system to index the student name, there are a couple of options for us to enable the index duplicates. No duplicate, so I think for the name, class, and class number, we should allow the duplicate. Last time we have mentioned a concept called alternate key, which is a non-primary key, but unfortunately in the Microsoft Access, there isn't such a concept. It's actually available for a lot of commercial systems other than the Microsoft Access, but we decided to skip it by now for simplicity. Now let's move on to create activity table. Next one, the activity participation. Now we're gonna pick the primary key. Could you think of the choice of primary key for the participation table? The answer is just pick both of them, because for the participation table, the key is to identify which student to attend which activity. It is a composite key, it makes sense. After we finish defining all the structures, let's move on to input some of data. Start with the students table first. Move back to the datasheet wheel. So it should pass, no problem. How about next record 0456007? Now there is a validation error. There's a prompt here. It says one of the values are prohibited by the validation rule. It should be like S. Are the numbers. I miss an S here, so it shouldn't pass. The domain integrity rule, like the validation rule, are enforced. It's functioning. As I add the S, it's okay now. How about the next one? If it's not the Lao X, it's Lao 0. So what's going to happen? There's another prompt here. For this rule, we only accept the alphabets or the space, but not other kind of characters. So it's not accepted here. Now I input as allow x, should be okay now. How about for the class? Let's try an example of 7f. Here is the prompt again. It should be like form 1 to form 6, A to E. We change it back to 6A. It's okay now. Class number, how about 41? Again, the validation rule is working properly. So now we set it back as the original value in our exam. It should be, no. For the class, it should be 1E. And 20. This is how our sample goes. And then for this record, I'd leave the student ID empty to see how it goes. They said this is an error. This is a sign that the entity integrity rule has been enforced. That means the primary key shouldn't be left empty. So let's just try to fill in a valid primary key. So it's alright now. Fast forward to input all the data. It's done on the student table. For the other tables, just me to input all the data, nothing special. I just try to quickly finish it. Finally, the participation table. As we have already set up all the data and structures, now we're gonna set up all the relationships. Hit the database to relationships. Select all of them, hit add. We got one student to attend many activities. Drag the student ID to the activity table. The fields are matching. Here, we got an option about enforcing the referential integrity. As we recall in the previous video, we have mentioned the referential integrity means all the student IDs should exist in the students table, otherwise they shouldn't be allowed. For the cascade update, it's like whenever I update the student ID here, I also update the student ID here in the participation table so that it can still refer to the records. For the cascade delete, it's like when I delete a student from the students table, I also delete the participation data from the participation table. How about the relationship type? There isn't any kind of choices here. The reason is that as we define the keys of different table, the access system will try to determine which kind of the relationship it is depending on how you set up all the keys. If you think that the relation type doesn't make sense, it could possibly mean that the key settings was not set up properly. We can just go back to the design view and fix the design before we move on. So the things that appear here should make sense. And then finally, we can click create. Oh, this is a very common error message because each time for us to work on the relationships, we should first close all of the tables that involve. So we can try to close all of them and then try again. So it's working now. For the activities table, the process should be similar. That's done. Yes. Go back to the participation table. Let's try out the referential integrity function here. When we go back to the students table, we do not have student code S999999. Let's try S999999. Maybe just dance. So you see the error message. You couldn't add or change the record because the relative record is required in the students table. That means in the students table, we don't have such student as S999999. So the system won't let you to add this record. It's working here. We can just press escape for this record. So I think that's it for the implementation. Here are the keywords for today. If you like this video, hit thumbs up and comments down below. Also subscribe to my channel. Catch up with you guys next time.